Hello and welcome to Call of Chemistry. This will be a third video of some basic concepts of chemistry series. In the last video, we ended up with the Avogadro's law. In this video, we move on to the next portion of this chapter. So let's start. So our next topic is atomic mass. We actually calculate the relative atomic mass. Relative atomic mass is mass of an atom of an element of the element upon 1/12 into mass of an atom of carbon. That is C12. The unit by which the mass of an atom of the element is expressed accurately is atomic mass unit, or simply AMU. So 1 AMU is basically 1/12 into mass of one atom of carbon, that is C12. Very often we say that mass of carbon is 12 gram per mole. Now what does it mean? It means 1 mole of 12 C atoms mass is 12 gram. In other words, mass of 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 number of 12 C is 12 gram. Hence, mass of 1 12 C atom will be 12 upon 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 gram. Now 1 AMU is 1/12 into mass of one atom of carbon, that is C12. So mass of one atom of carbon is, this is, so here we put that 12 upon 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. So we found that the value is 1.6605 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. So this is a very important relation, 1 AMU and 1 gram and gram. So mass of an element, so simply we can say that is relative atomic mass into 1 AMU, because we can see that relative atomic mass is equal to mass of an atom of the element by 1/12 into mass of an atom of carbon, and this value is nothing but 1 AMU. This value is 1 AMU, and we cross multiplication, we can tell that mass of an element is relative atomic mass into 1 AMU. So we can simplify that relative atomic mass into 1.6605 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. Because 1 mu is nothing but 1.6605 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. So here we can derive that relation. Then what does it mean by mass of one atom of hydrogen is 1.008 mu? What does it mean by mass of one atom of hydrogen is 1.008 mu? It means 1.008 mu is equal to 1.008 into 1.6605 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. This is nothing but mass of an atom of one hydrogen, and this is nothing but relative atomic mass of one hydrogen, and this is 1 mu. Just the application of this relation. So we can say that 1.008 mu of hydrogen is basically 1.008 into 1.6605 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram of hydrogen. Now, atomic mass of an element is expressed by gram, but relative atomic mass is a unitless quantity. Atomic mass of an element is gram, and relative atomic mass is unitless quantity. Because relative atomic mass is nothing but the ratio of two same amount of mass. That is, the relative atomic mass is mass of an atom of the element and 1/12 into mass of an atom of carbon. So ratio of two same units, so it is unitless quantity. Now we'll discuss about average atomic mass. What is the reason that atomic mass of elements are always fractional quantity but not integers? The reason is most of the elements exist as mixture of isotopes in nature. So while calculating of atomic mass, we have to take average of atomic masses of all isotopes. That's why the atomic mass of an element is fractional quantity. So average atomic mass is summation of percentage abundance of isotope into atomic mass of isotope. That is summation of percentage abundance of isotope into atomic mass of isotope upon 100. We will understand by an example. There are two isotopes of chlorine, that is 35Cl and 37Cl, and the natural abundance is such that 3:1, and 35Cl has the mass, atomic mass 35 amu, and 37Cl has the atomic mass 37 amu. So from the ratio we can calculate the percentage abundance of 35Cl and 37Cl, that is percentage abundance of 35Cl is 3 upon 3 plus 1 into 100, that is 75%, and the percentage abundance of 37Cl is 1 upon 1 plus 3 into 100, that is 25%. So applying the formula we can calculate the average atomic mass. So average atomic mass of chlorine is 75 was the natural abundance of 35Cl, and its atomic mass is 35 amu, plus 25% was the natural abundance of 37Cl. So here 25 into, and the atomic mass of 37Cl is 37 amu upon 100, that is 35.5 amu. Now we move on to the molecular mass. Now what is the difference between molecular mass and formula mass? Difference between molecular mass and formula mass. We will understand the difference with the example of sodium chloride. The molecular mass of sodium chloride, if a statement tells molecular mass of sodium chloride is 58.5, then the statement is wrong. Why? Because there is no existence of NaCl molecule. In the crystal of NaCl, Na plus and Cl minus ions get packed like a cube, where each Na plus is surrounded by 6 Cl minus and vice versa. So this is actually wrong statement, because there is no existence of NaCl molecule in crystal of NaCl. Each Na plus is surrounded by 6 Cl minus ions and vice versa. That's why we can say that formula mass can be expressed for all compounds, but molecular mass cannot be, because molecular mass is applicable only those compounds which exist as molecule. Here NaCl does not exist as molecules, for that NaCl formula mass is applicable. I think it is clear the difference between molecular mass and formula mass. Now we move on to mole concept and molar mass. One mole is equivalent to 6.022 × 10²³ particles. Similarly, one mole of oxygen Carton contains 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 atoms of oxygen. One mole of oxygen molecule contains 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 molecules of oxygen. And similarly, one mole of potassium ion corresponds 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 number of potassium ions. This is how we can correlate between moles and the number of particles. Now, what does it mean by gram atomic mass of oxygen is 16 gram? What does it mean? It means six point zero two two into 10 to the power 23 number of atoms, because here is gram atomic mass, number of atoms mass is 16 gram. Similarly, mass of one atom of oxygen is 16 upon 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. This 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 also expressed as Ne, that is Avogadro number. An important point is, look, 1 AMU is basically 1 by Avogadro number of Avogadro number gram, because we see from the AMU, that is here we can see that this 12 and 12 cancel out and is basically 1 upon 6.022 into 10 to the power 23, that is nothing but 1 AMU. So here also we can write that 1 AMU is equal to 1 upon Na gram, that is 1.6605 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. This also called, this amount also called 1 avogram or 1 Dalton. Now we move on to normal density of gases. In STP, that is 1 atmospheric pressure and 273 Kelvin temperature, that is basically in STP. In STP, normal density is mass of gas in gram and by upon volume of gas in liters. Then a term comes which is known as relative density or the vapor density. Relative density or vapor density is expressed as mass of gas whose volume is V at STP upon mass of hydrogen gas whose volume is V at HTP. From this, we can write that mass of gas whose volume is 1 liter at HTP, and this also we can write mass of hydrogen gas whose volume is 1 liter at HTP. Simply we divide both numerator and denominator by V, so we can get that mass of gas whose volume is 1 liter at HTP upon mass of hydrogen gas whose volume is 1 liter at HTP, and this is nothing but normal density of that gas upon normal density of hydrogen gas. From the definition of normal density, we wrote that normal density is equal to mass of gas in gram upon volume of gas in liter. So here mass of gas per liter of volume of this gas is known as normal density of that gas, and mass of hydrogen gas whose volume is 1 liter at HTP is nothing but normal density of H2 gas. So we can write that normal density of gas is vapor density of that gas into normal density of H2 gas, that is 0.089 gram per liter. We started the expression of vapor density. So vapor density is equal to normal density of that gas upon normal density of hydrogen gas. So now an important statement is molecular weight of a gas is twice its vapor density. This is very, very important statement. We can derive the relation such that at same temperature and pressure, vapor density of a gas, we wrote the relation, that is mass of gas whose volume is V upon mass of hydrogen gas whose volume is V. So from the expression of vapor density, we can find that mass of gas whose volume is V at HTP and upon mass of hydrogen gas whose volume is V at HTP. From that, we simply write this one: vapor density of a gas, mass of gas whose volume is V upon mass of hydrogen gas whose volume is V, and we fix the temperature and pressure. Now, according to Avogadro's law, at same temperature and pressure equal volume of all gases contain equal number of molecules. So from that we can write vapor density of a gas is mass of gas containing n molecules upon mass of hydrogen gas containing n molecules. Because both the volume is same, that is V. So the number of molecules will be the same for both the gas and the hydrogen gas according to Avogadro's law. Then we can say that mass of gas containing one molecule upon mass of hydrogen gas containing one molecule. Simply we divide by n in both numerator and denominator. So we can get that mass of gas containing one molecule upon mass of hydrogen gas containing one molecule. We can also write that mass of gas containing one molecule upon mass of two hydrogen atoms, because we know that mass of two hydrogen atoms is basically the mass of one molecule of hydrogen. We can write that in such a way, half into mass of gas containing one molecule upon mass of one hydrogen atom, because we leave two, then mass of one hydrogen atom will be here, then half into, now see, look very carefully, this term is basically known as molecular weight, because molecular weight is nothing but mass of gas containing one molecule upon mass of one hydrogen atom. We calculate the molecular weight relatively in such a way. So we can write that molecular weight is nothing but 2 into vapor density. This is a very important relation. So by this I am stopping here. If you have any doubt, please let me know in the comment section. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.